Hello students, in this video I will discuss about the basic structure of the operational amplifier or simply an op-amp. Let's start with the definition of an op-amp. So an op-amp is a high gain multi-stage direct coupled differential amplifier in which a feedback is added to improve its overall response characteristic. Now in this definition you can see that there are different words which should be explained to you. These words are high gain, multi-stage, direct coupled, differential amplifier and feedback. So let's start our discussion from high gain. Actually op-amp, if you consider this word, the full form is operational amplifier. So basically it is an amplifier, and as you know that every amplifier is used to get some amplification or some gain. So this device or an op-amp is actually a very large gain amplifier. Basically or typically the gain of an op-amp is nearly 10 to the power 4 to 10 to the power 5. Now then the question arises that what is a multi-stage amplifier? A multi-stage amplifier means this type of amplifier consists of different stages. Later on in this video, I will show you that the block diagram of an op-amp can be divided into four different stages. That's why it is a multi-stage amplifier. Then comes what is a direct coupled amplifier. As you know that every stages of an amplifier should be coupled with the previous stage of the amplifier with either a resistance or a capacitor or a combination of R and C. But this type of amplifier or this op-amp, here the different stages are directly coupled with each other. Okay. Now let's discuss about the differential amplifier. Actually, when an amplifier can amplify its different signals of the input voltages, these type of amplifiers are regarded or called as differential amplifier. Now, op-amp is basically a differential amplifier as it can amplify the difference of its input voltages. Okay? Then the last term, that is feedback. Now, as you know that whenever a portion or the entire of the output voltage of an amplifier is fed back to its input, the process is known as feedback. And everywhere a feedback is added to improve the overall response characteristic of the amplifier. So here the definition of an op-amp tells us that it is a high gain multi-stage direct coupled differential amplifier in which a feedback is added to improve its overall response characteristic. Okay, remember this definition. Now as you can see that this is the block diagram of an op-amp. Here there are four blocks, so that's why op-amp is a multi-stage amplifier. This is the first block and this is the input stage. Input stage of an op-amp is actually consisting of two inputs. One is the non-inverting input and the other is the inverting input. After that, the second stage is the intermediate stage. The third is the level shifting stage. And the last one, that is the fourth stage, is the output stage, after which the output from an op-amp is derived. The input stage is the dual input balanced output differential amplifier, and this stage generally provides most of the voltage gain of the amplifier and also establishes the input resistance of the op-amp. Let's discuss about this stage elaborately. So this is the circuit of a dual input balanced output differential amplifier. In this circuit there are two NPN transistors, Q1 and Q2 are used. As you can see there are two resistors at the collector ends, that is RC1, RC2, and two resistances are at the emitter ends of the two transistors. These are RE1 and RE2. The two input voltages are V1, V2 or VIN1, VIN2, and there are two supply voltages. These are the biasing voltages of an op-amp, that is plus VCC and minus VEE. Now, here, as it is a balanced output differential amplifier, it means that the V0 or the output voltage is actually the difference between the two collector voltages of Q1 and Q2. So, V0 is actually VC1 difference VC2. Now, in the intermediate stage, where another differential amplifier is used, but this is driven by the output of the first stage, that is the input stage. Now, in most amplifiers, the intermediate stage is a dual input unbalanced, that is a single-ended output, as because direct coupling is used, so the DC voltage at the output of the intermediate stage is well above ground potential. Therefore, generally the level transistor or the shifting stage, that is the third stage circuit, is used after the intermediate stage to shift the DC level at the output of the intermediate stage downward to 0 volts with respect to ground. And the final stage is actually a push-pull complementary amplifier output stage. This output stage increases the output voltage swing and raises the current supplying capability of the op-amp. A well-designed output stage also provides low output resistance for an op-amp. So this is all about the block diagram of an op-amp. Let's draw the schematic symbol for an op-amp. This triangular base structure is the schematic symbol for an op-amp. Here you can see there are two inputs, and these two inputs are pointed as plus and minus. The plus input is known as the non-inverting input, and the minus polarity input is the inverting input. And there are two voltage supplies, or these are the biasing voltages, as I have told earlier, that is plus VCC and minus VEE, and an op-amp has a single output, that is V0. The plus input, which is the non-inverting input, and if you apply an AC signal or a DC voltage at this input, the output produces in phase or same polarity signal as the input. So that's why this input is known as the non-inverting input, while for an inverting input, that is the negative polarity input, if you apply an AC signal or a DC voltage to this input, that is the inverting input, you will find an output voltage with a 180 degree phase shift of the AC input signal, or a negative polarity or the opposite polarity output voltage for this inverting input. Now let's talk about the two different DC power supplies which are used in this op-amp circuit, that is the plus VCC and the minus VEE voltage sources. Actually, these two voltage sources are equal in magnitude and generally is taken as plus 15 volt and minus 15 volt. If you find this video useful, then please give me a thumbs up. In my next video, I will show you an ideal voltage transfer curve for an op-amp, and I will explain the different open loop and closed loop op-amp configurations, as well as the electrical characteristics of an ideal op-amp. So till then, goodbye.